Everyone, this is a dream vlog about Harry and I in London. I know last time I did a dream vlog, I mentioned that I was going to be doing this one, and it comes straight out of the old dream journal. So onwards we go. Harry and I were in London. However, this London looked a little bit strange. It looked like a post-war scene. It wasn't bombed or anything, but it just looked like it was a bit run down, a bit depressed. Kind of like how Scooby-Doo, like amusement parks, always look a bit strange. Anyway, we had no money and we needed to travel to the cinema, which was a very, very long way away to walk. So because we didn't have enough money for the train, we didn't have enough money for the underground tube system, we only had enough money for buses. So we decided to take a bus. However, the buses in this dream didn't operate at all what they would like operate in waking life. They were kind of like elevators underground, and they were really tight and compact, and they would travel like in all directions, and all the elevators would work together to make sure they don't crash into each other. It's kind of like how the Ministry of Magic's elevators work in Harry Potter, or how the boxes operate in that film Cabin in the Woods. Good film, that. Good film. Another weird thing about these buses was the fact that not only were they underground, but the entrance to the bus terminal, or the different stops and stations, they were in people's houses because everyone lived underground for some reason. So you'd have to break into someone's house, find the specific door in their house, open it up, and hope to the best that there is the elevator. And basically, you'd walk into the room, there'd be a little ledge, and then the elevator in front, and you get in with like 5-10 other people, and it's all cramped and all crowded, and it was dimly lit. I don't know where the lights were from. It was just very weirdly lit and it's horrible, musty and exposed, but yet cramped at the same time. So me and Harry get onto this bus after breaking into someone's house. We get onto the bus or elevator. We get in, we get off in someone else's house. And then we have to find another door in their house to find the link to the other bus to get to the cinema station. So we're desperately trying to find this bus and we don't know where it is. So we open a door, we think, oh, this might be it. And it's a little ramp going up towards the roof. So we head up towards the roof and we can breathe fresh air, which is nice for a change. We go up towards the roof and there was nothing there. There was a box, which is probably the electric box because it made like this buzzing, like humming noise. So it's probably electric box that was powering the entire flat. So Harry got really annoyed and really tired at the same time, which isn't usually like him. If we're usually doing something, he's like really proactive. So this was against his character. But he just curled up into a little ball and just slept next to the electric box. Like he was like a wild animal that just found some dying embers of an old fire that somebody had just not put out properly. And he was cuddling up to get warm. That was what it was like. And it was very, very surreal, and I got really annoyed at him. I was like, Harry, come on, we have to do this. But he just didn't care. He was sound asleep next to the electric box, all nice and warm, didn't care. So I carried on. I did manage to find the elevator, or the bus, rather, and I did manage to find myself to the bus station outside the cinema. And I was looking around at all the signs because I was a tourist and I was saying, oh, okay, town map sign. I was looking at the town map and I thought, oh, there's the cinema. It's a 15-minute walk, which in the dream I was like, oh, that's so much better. But waking up and looking back at it, I'm like, 15-minute walk? That's nowhere near the cinema. There's got to be a stop that would be closer to that cinema. Never mind. So I walked to the cinema. Oh, before I went to the cinema and went to the station, I found the station, as I mentioned. And then I went back to Harry. And when I went back to Harry, I said to him, look, mate, I found the bus station. You coming with me? And he was all like, no, I'm not coming back with you. And I was like, fine, stay there. So then I got onto the bus. Then I got to the cinema station. And then I walked to the cinema. And everyone was asking where Harry was. And I told him he's sleeping on a roof next to an electric box. And they just seemed to be fine with that. And that was my dream. It's very strange one. A few things. Next week's Tuesday video is going to be about a Q&A session. I've already got the question and answers ready for that episode. But if you want to be involved in the next Q&A that I do, which probably won't be for a few weeks yet, then head over to my Facebook or my Twitter page at Giz Edwards And you be the first, that was a weird way of saying, you would be the first to find out when I'm doing a Q&A. You also have your opportunity to ask me some stuff about me, maybe lucid dreaming, whatever you want to know. So, next video is going to be on Thursday, so 2 days' time, and it's going to be about napping. So